Approaching 3 minutes played. Outside Canada. Pass to Charles. Uses
the glass, though, getting away. Only one player in the history of the WNBA has made more two-point buckets than Tina Charles. Making hoops inside is her bread and butter.
A wide-open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Atlanta trailing here. And Mabry picks up the foul. That'll be her second foul of the game.
Third team foul. Checking in for Chicago, Dana Evans.
Pass to Charles. Down and goes for a third basket and many traps. Nice low post offense. Here's Williams. And it's Atlanta with the rebound. Fast break, here come the three. Three, Ryan Howard. It's hauled in by Harrison. Outside to Shields. Second shot opportunity, and it's good on the lay in.
Protecting the play, Harrison fights to retain possession and get him a bucket.
Inside. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
It makes it so easy for Jordan to lead her to the rim with a pass like that.
Harrison gets the bucket.
She was one step ahead of the D in making that pass. Nice assist.
Down low. Here's Charles. That one goes down 4-4.
That pass allowed her to get straight to the rim in perfect stride.
Here's Williams. And the three off target. And so here's Atlanta. They trail by three. Got that bucket and no time at all.
This is probably the best range for Canada. Much more comfortable shooting it from 15 to 25.
Onion Wade shot is good.
What a start to this game. All offense early.
Yeah, this is just playground stuff. Forget about defending. Just keep letting the fly.
That's okay with me.
Howard can't get it to go. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock and game clock. And Williams gets it to go.
One of her real strengths, Williams can collect her teammates' misses, turn them into points.
There's the triple. Howard misses. Now here's Evans. Defense is right there. Here's Williams. And she uses the glass on the layup.
He got caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance points.
They need more effort than that on the boards. That can't happen.
Offense coming free and easy as we wrap 16. Up the first quarter.
Chicago.
Sky out in front. Up. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. Chicago leading. Outside to Shields. Bangs home the trifecta.
The lift on the J for DeShields is just so good. She can really get up when she's set up right.
On the wing, Alicia Gray. They waste no time getting those 3 points back.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Just trading punches to Tom Ray.
It's a heavyweight fight. Password. Assist is right on target.
And here are the dream. And Mabry picks up the foul. That's her third foul of the game.
Personal foul. First team foul.
Canada with it. Gray outside.
A bigger guard slash wing at 6'1", DeShields can lock down players at positions 1 through 4. What an advantage to this team in today's WNBA.
Alicia Gray, she's open. The offensive rebound. Bucket is good.
Battle for offensive rebounds. Guaranteed a high-quality shot on the follow, just like she got there.
Time called here in the sky. Excited to talk about it. Looks like the coach saw some things out there that he adjusted. It's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
Williams. Chicago again missing. Williams pulls it in. That's a surprise. Out of character for her to miss those when the D's not right to the tape. And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second period. Shot by Charles. A multiple time scoring champ. Tina Charles can put up huge numbers any night, even well into her 30s. And Atlanta has possession. It's a 5-point game. Who was supposed to be on her there, and apparently neither did the defenders. Now here is Howard. Atlanta calls timeout.
It's T-shirt Bonanza. Make some noise.
Second free throw, no good. And it's the sky ball. They've led by as much as 10. Onyewede, shot is good.
I just love a player like her. She's been the floor general at the offensive end.
She has been on it today, just doing a great job of keeping that ball moving. As a player, you always want to be able to answer back.
Got 13. And the three ball is good.
I love it. Keep shooting. As the threes keep dropping for her, she'll keep shooting. Keep shooting.
As she should. Look, when you're having the kind of day she's having, why not just keep firing?
Check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates on the same page. For three. And again, it's the sky from deep. Trusting in her shot. Onyewede, ready to train it. As soon as she got the feet. Outside Canada. Charles.
Yeah, certainly their deficit would be a lot bigger if it wasn't for her efficiency at the offensive end of the floor.
Here's Harrison. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
Down the floor, Onyewede providing the assist to a very open teammate.
To the middle. Out hard that time. And the shots alive. That one on the shields.
Well, defense looking to protect the rim at all costs there.
Something you struggle with in your career, Tim, but definitely saved the layup with that foul. She's going to have to earn him at the line.
And that's good as she hits both shots. Chicago now. They lead by 7. And Williams gets it to go.
That's not an easy do. Good concentration by Williams to get the bucket. A focused player.
Here's Canada. To the inside. Powers. Laid in with a nice touch on the ball.
Beautiful dish down low.
Chicago with the ball. Here's Onyewede. Canada grabs the board. Tries it from 19. Power shot
That's a shoot-around jumper. Absolutely no excuses for missing it.
Takes the three. That one doesn't drop.
You can tell she thought that triple was going to fall.
She's just shaking her head after that miss.
Power gets the bucket.
The efficiency of Power's passing is great. Delivers the ball straight to a wide-open shooter.
Williams can't get it to go.
Get set for the second half to get underway. One of the stories here, Anya Nwede getting it done today.
Yeah, those threes have been dropping for her. Absolute dead-eye shooting at that first half.
Yeah, I'll say. I mean, this could not have been a more productive day for her for long range.
And it's been a back-and-forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here. Here's Williams. Target from three-point range. Atlanta trailing here. Canada with it. Picked up by Harrison. To the middle. Gets to the rim.
Just a really fast rookie basketball. Canada's always up there in terms of league leaders in assists.
Harrison no good. One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough for the fans. The road back into this game might be a short one, but they've managed to make it all the way back and tie this game up.
And I'll admit it, at one point I thought they were toast. They've shown some serious character to battle this far back.
And I thought they were toast too, with the butter and jelly and everything on it.
Here's Howard. It's deflected.
Harrison very engaged.
Here's Evans. Buries the long range jumper.
Fed her teammate off the bounce there. That was a nice play.
Now here's Canada. He's tightly guarded.
Retaliation right there, huh, guys?
Yeah, sure didn't take him long to go and get those 3 points back.
Williams. Play with just over 1.5 minutes gone by. Howard, and Wade covering. And that puts them in the lead.
With good size for the guard position, Ryan Howard is able to use that size to stretch the floor.
That shot by Wade, no good. Atlanta in the lead. A good look for Ryan Howard. It's hauled in by Harrison. On offense, here the Sky. Back of the rim.
As a big, sometimes your height is a huge help passing-wise. It allows players like Williams to get a clear view of open players.
And she comes up with the finish.
Great communication between teammates there.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Harrison no good. And so here's Atlanta. Two-point game. Three, Ryan Howard. Elizabeth Williams with the rebound.
Just like me, times out of 10, she's going to bury the three when she's left all alone like that.
Mabry, guarded by Canada. The three-pointer off the mark. Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half.
Passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for
her. It's stolen by Elizabeth Williams. Wasted no time on that one. And so here's Atlanta. They lead by one. Canada with it, working on Harrison. And she converts the layup. I
don't think as many of those high percentage shots they can make.
Now, if I'm not home by Chicago. One player who's been getting it done is Keena Charles.
You can attack him from the floor, just to the dive of the ball in the paint, hit her away from the front end.
Outside Evans. Let's go with a three. The basket good on the assist for Marina Mabry.
Well, straight up, the defense, they cannot let Evans get breathing room. But this is going to happen for me.
Coffee outside. Wide open. And there's another one by the three.
Assisted by Jordan.
On offense near the sky. Down low. Here's Harrison. And she's facing the layup.
Now this is where Harrison is at her best. Scoring inside. She's a five. She plays like a five.
Side Mabry. Kennedy Carter for three. And again, Kennedy Carter with a three.
With her quick first step, Carter should always be able to get threes off. Defenders have to give her a little space or we'll get burned.
It's good.
Make that pass to a spot and let her teammate run right into it. That is how you distribute the basketball.
From outside the arc. And it's Dana Evans with veterans.
I like seeing Evans shoot while in rhythm. She knows how to punish the defense off the dribble.
Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Ray, no good. Chicago in the lead. Shoots the three. And it's Dana Evans with the treble.
Yeah, she's found a rhythm here in the third quarter, and you can sense her confidence. Everything she puts up from long range seems to fall.
That shot by Howard, no good. And that's the end of first quarter. The three more games, both teams playing well. And Sky up by seven. And we've got more exciting basketball action coming your way right after the break.
Just like this one each and every night. This one's a beauty.
It sure is. I mean, look, she's a maestro. Great vision, a great head on her shoulders, really everything you want in a point guard.
Welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. And stolen by Mabry. From three-point range.
It has been a three-point barrage for them since halftime.
Yeah, I don't know if it's been by design or by accident, but either way, it's been impressive.
Maybe the coach just went up to the locker room chalkboard and put a number three out there. Oh, it's good thing she showed up today, because without her, they'd be in deeper trouble.
Here's Onyewede. And again, it's the sky from deep.
Get it, Onyewede. Oh, Wim, who does a little bit of everything on the floor, and that makes her a difficult matchup.
Here's Canada. They shoot again. Chicago with the rebound. And so it looks like the sky will retain possession here.
Nice play to get a hand to that pass.
just a hair away from coming up with the steal there. Good effort.
Took him no time at all on that one.
Man, this fourth quarter has been tremendous, really, for them from three-point range.
Yeah, a ton of their points coming from long range here. What a barrage.
And what a time to hit the threes. Well, this run has really widened the gap in the game. They are way out in front.
This has been a back-breaking run, really exposing the weakness in their defense.
Out of bounds, it'll go to the sky.
We've seen a lot of silly plays like that out of them today. Way too many.
Outside Williams, Mabry, and again, Indiana with a three.
And their lead gets even more enormous. They've played terrific basketball at both ends.
No doubt about it. I certainly can't think of an area where they've underperformed.
And neither can I.
Atlanta calls timeout. One of the stories here, Onion Wade getting it done today.
She is on fire from beyond the arc.
She's making a play. A little over a minute and a half of the fourth quarter gone now.
Boy, I mean, they can do nothing right. They cannot take the lid off.
They need a bucket in the worst way possible. They have got to stop this run somehow, or it's really going to get out of hand.
On the wing, Ryan Howard.
That one's on target for the win.
I love Howard's decision-making offensively, especially off the catch right there.
Tries for 10, and it's Chicago with another.
Well, there's hot guys, and there's really hot. They can't miss.
Sometimes an individual will go on a shooting tear like this, but a whole team?
This is special, Brian.
Kept alive. Charles with the bucket.
Easily one of the most tenacious rebounders in the league. Charles is very familiar with second chance points.
Scooped up. Here's Harrison. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there. Pass to Canada. Coffee. Good. And Jordan Canada gets the assist.
Confidence throw from downtown. Mia Coffee can really hit those.
Harrison, and there are the sky with another bucket. Fourth quarter keeps moving along. 3 minutes gone by now. That's tipped and stolen by Mabry. Fast break Chicago. Onion Wade shot is good.
Good work by Mabry applying pressure on the defensive end, forcing a turnover.
And Atlanta has possession. Canada with it. And Williams picks her up defensively.
Even though she's little compared to the bigger players on the floor, she's done some tall work on the boards.
Onion Wade. Williams. Great positioning on the putback.
That's some nice work on the offensive glass.
If you're just tuning in, welcome. We've played about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Charity stripe shot. Shot by Canada, no good.
Not sure what the D was doing there. She's not the player to give open looks to, but they got away with it that time.
Sinks the triple.
A player, you just need to run off of her shot. When DeShields gets comfortable shooting, she's that much better.
Inside. Can they get it? Here's Charles. Tries again. And she lays it up and in.
Terrific job to convert the putback. She stayed with that play from start to finish, and that's something we say about her a lot.
Harrison gets her bucket.
Well, it wasn't already out of reach. It is now thanks to the spurt that they're having.
And why put on the brakes now, Tim? I say just keep on firing.
Hey, Brian, you want to run up the score?
Right side, Charles. That's good, and it's off.
It's not just close in. Charles also flourishes in the mid-range. Unfair to stop. Well, she's definitely a threat for Pete, but it just hasn't been going for her tonight. You might want to avoid that shot for a while.
And it's Gray missing.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308% maybe.
Okay, I like that.
Here's Harrison. A beautiful reverse layup.
A throwback in the front court. Harrison can score in bunches without knocking down threes. Does it the old-fashioned way for a big.
Outside Howard. No good with the triple. Outside to Shields. The trade, and it counts. No problem for Chicago as they get the win. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says an awful lot about this team.
Yeah, Blake, I guess they don't need home cooking. Like, you know, you're cooking for your mom to feel at home. Just a masterful performance all around for them.
So that's going to do it for this one, folks.